Hi DIYers, Sterling with Alarm Grid here. Today we're going to show you how to program a 5811 wireless door or window sensor. The 5811 is our personal favorite wireless door contact that can be used with a Honeywell wireless system, whether it's a Vista security system with a wireless receiver attached, or a Lynx Touch or Lynx Plus system. This has been by far the most popular sensor because of the size of the sensor. You can see how thin it will be, very thin off of the wall, small footprint, looks really nice, blends in nicely to your decor when you install the sensor. Okay, so while this sensor is a 5800 series sensor, which is the old style of RF technology that was used with Honeywell wireless systems, you still can use this type of sensor with the Honeywell Lyric panel because the Lyric is backwards compatible and supports 5800 series sensors. So the Lyric has a different kind of door contact that it'll come with by default, which is a 6 sensor. 6 is the new wireless technology that the Honeywell sensors are going to use with the Lyric. And those 6 sensors will be encrypted and therefore more secure when communicating from the sensor to the panel. But if you have existing 5811s in your house, you certainly can use them with the Lyric. So to program the device, the first thing we need to do, it comes with the back plate removed from the circuit board and the cover, and it comes with a battery in a little plastic bag. And this is a Panasonic CR2032 battery, 3-volt lithium coin cell battery. And when you're looking at the internal circuitry of the 5811, you have the circuit board in this portion, and this open circle here is for the battery. And there's a little negative indicator on the plastic, which the negative side is underneath, and you put the positive side up and you snap it in place. There's two little plastic tabs that hold it down. It's getting its connection, and you can see a little positive symbol here, you know you have it installed the right way. Then you can close the sensor up. There's two tabs at the bottom, and then it snaps shut up at the top. And now we have our magnet and our sensor ready to learn in. So to program to the panel, we have to access the programming level or the installer level programming. And to do that, we have to hit from the home screen, actually, at Security, Tools, and the default installer code, 4112. We have not yet changed our installer code, so that's what we're gonna use. If you do not have monitoring active on your Lyric system, once you access programming, you'll be shown this screen asking to connect to the server. This wants to associate the panel with an AlarmNet account. Unless you're working with your alarm company, just ignore this screen and say no, because the programming can be done without that association, and you're gonna have that question until it gets associated. So we're just gonna skip past that. Now that we're in here, if we hit program and zones, we can see that we're in this level of programming where we can select any zone available. This system supports quite a few zones. If you scroll down, you can go all the way to zone 130, which the last four, 127 and 130, are garage door zones. But basically, this system supports 130 zones of protection, plus some key fob zones and some temperature zones if you're using Z-Wave thermostats, and then some keypad zones and some panic zones. So a lot of zones that this system supports. The first two are hardwired zones, so unless you're using a hardwired sensor, don't worry about those. And the next four zones are set up as template zones out of the box. You'll see front door, back door, window, and motion sensor. So we're going to go ahead and use the front door template. We highlight zone 3 and click edit. And we'll see that it's set with some default parameters. Front as the zone description, device type is door, and response type is entry exit 1. All right, so before we get into all of those options, we want to first associate the serial number, which is displayed on this barcode sticker. It always starts with an A for alpha on a 5811 sensor, followed by a 7-digit number. That sticker also was inside the device when we had it open. And we can either type that number in or we can activate the device three times. And to activate a 5811, you simply put the magnet in between the two little hash marks that are on this long edge. They're only on one long edge. This long edge is smooth, but this long edge has the two hash marks. You put the magnet there and you pull it away. You put it back and you have your first beep, your first fault indication. We do that again. It is best to pause and wait a few seconds between each activation. The first one beeped once, the second one beeps twice, puts in the appropriate serial number, 0233641, along with the loop number of 1, which is the proper loop when using a 5811. And we can either hit done and take us back to the other screen, or what I like to do, just to verify everything is working one more time, is to fault it a third time. And now we have the serial number in the top box locked in with the loop number of 1. So the loop is a way to tell the system what action this device is doing. For a 5811, it only does one action, which is alarm when the motion is, or the magnet is away. So we want loop number 1. That is referenced in the 5811 installation guide. So if you're ever wondering about the loops, check your particular sensor's installation guide and it will tell you which loops to use or which loop to use. All right, we're gonna leave it as front door because that happens to be where we're gonna program this, or put this rather. But if you wanted, you could clear that out and you could call it back door. So this is a library. You don't just type, you hit a letter and then it takes you through the available words in that library for that letter. All right, so side door you would hit, side door you hit an S and then an I, and you would see the word side and you could save it. For our case, we want front, so we hit an F. We can hit the down arrow to go through until we get to front, or we can use a shortcut and put an R, and it'll jump to the first FR word. If we do one more shortcut, it'll jump to the first FRO word, which happens to be front, and we save it. So front door, and then response type is the last question that, the next question that we want to answer. When any door sensor, you're choosing almost every single time entry exit 1 or perimeter. There are other options that you can select for more custom stuff, but entry exit 1 or perimeter will be by far the majority of the two response types you'll use when learning in a door sensor. And the question to ask yourself is, will I use this door when the system is armed? Okay? Will I open the door to come in when it's armed? Or when I'm in the house and armed, will I ever want to open that door to leave? If you say yes to either of those questions, you want to select entry exit 1. And then this device will follow the entry delay and the exit delay programmed in the system. So if you're armed, when you arm it, you have 60 seconds of an exit delay by default. And with it selected entry exit 1, that means you'd have 60 seconds to open this door, close this door, and get out of the property before it's armed without setting off an alarm. Same idea, when it's armed and you come home, this door opens, the panel will start to beep, and the entry delay period will start. By default, that's 30 seconds. As long as you get to the keypad or use a key fob or Total Connect to disarm the system within 30 seconds, no alarm is triggered. So the doors that you use when it's armed, you want entry exit 1. If you said, I only use my garage door to enter the property, never my front door, you could also select perimeter. That's the alternative selection. And what a perimeter zone type will do is, when you arm it, if this door opens, the alarm goes off right away, even during the exit countdown, because this is a door that should never be opened when the system is armed. Same idea, if you open the front door to come in because you lost your keys to the garage door, and therefore you have to come through the front door, as soon as you open that front door, the alarm will go off. And that's a more secure response type because obviously we were just describing what happens to you as the end user, but the other side to think about is what happens with the intruder. And with the intruder, if they open this door, because it's not a door that the family is going to be using when it's armed, it means it's a door that should go off and go into alarm mode immediately when triggered, so you get a faster response from the central station. So in our case, that's how we're going to set it up. We don't use the front door to enter or exit the property. We use a different alternative garage door. So we're gonna select perimeter and leave it perimeter. Alarm report is whether or not an activation of this alarm will send to the central station. In this case, the system will be monitored, so we're gonna leave that yes. And then chime, when the system is disarmed and the door opens, you can have it chime at the keypad, which means you get beeps and or voice enunciation of the door opening. And it is a selectable chime, so you can choose which tone you like best, and there's a few different options, and you just kind of toggle through and choose the one you want. These are the same options that the Lynx Touch 5200 and 7000 panels had. And we're gonna go ahead and just choose the standard chime, which is the beep beep. Supervision is the last question. Do you want the system to look periodically for this sensor and make sure that it's communicating properly? All right, so this sensor, when set to supervised, will send check-in messages to the panel every 70 to 90 minutes. And basically those check-in signals will reset an internal clock for this sensor, which runs backwards from 12 hours. It's basically a stopwatch running back for 12 hour period. Any alarms, troubles, faults, or 70 to 90 minute supervision check-in signals that are received properly by the panel resets the clock, goes back to 12 hours, starts to count down again. If 12 hours ever go by and we haven't seen any faults, troubles, alarms, or check-in messages from this sensor, then we'll get a supervision loss signal for this particular zone 3. And that would indicate that we have a range issue. This is installed in an area that it's not talking properly to the panel. All right, so if we had a mirror in a bathroom and this was on a door to the bathroom, in line of sight, this sensor was talking through that mirror. The backside of mirrors are really bad for RF transmissions. So you might get a supervision loss if you're installed that way. And again, it's every 12 hours, it's letting you know that this thing that's supposed to be checking in roughly every hour hasn't been able to check in at all. And then you know you have to reconsider your installation and see what you can do to get this signal back to the panel. So we always recommend supervise, that way you know. It also supervises the battery, so you'll know when the battery goes low. So we always like to have it supervised for maximum security. And then we save it. We've saved it as the front door, but we have our serial number in. And now if we exit to the home screen, we can see ready to arm. We have a comm trouble, but that's just a system trouble, not a sensor trouble. So we are ready to arm, and we're gonna show you what happens simulating this program sensor when the door opens. The magnet would move away from the sensor, and you can see immediately it went to not ready to arm. And it shows you open 3 front door. If you hit zones, you can also see the fault indication on the front door. You could bypass it if you wanted to arm it with it open, or it's letting you know you better close the door. It goes right back to ready to arm. It'll no longer scroll through that open front door zone option, and we know the sensor is working. If we want to enable chime, we can show you how the chime mode works as well. So if we turn chime on and we do that same faulting, you can hear the panel gives you the beep beep chime along with the audible spoken words of front door. So you know that it's checking in. If you're watching your kids going out to the pool, the chime mode's a great way to keep track of what's happening even when the system is off or disarmed. So that's how to program a 5811 wireless door or window sensor to your Honeywell Lyric security system. We hope you've enjoyed this video and found it to be helpful for your installation. And if you have any questions on using a 5811 or programming it to a Honeywell Lyric, please email support@alarmgrid.com and make sure to subscribe to our channel so that you'll be up to date with all of the great new videos that we'll be releasing on this revolutionary new system.